I've become borderline obsessed with generative AI chatbots like ChatGPT, and it seems I'm not the only one. Everyone's talking about them, but while generative AI chatbots are the current hot topic, another form of chatbot, rule-based chatbots, have been around for years. So, what's the difference? Do they work in the same way, or has generative AI made rule-based chatbots obsolete? Let's take a look. So let's begin with a few definitions. Generative AI chatbots utilize LLMs, or large language models, to generate responses based on user inputs. And they are trained on massive data sets containing billions of words, phrases, and sentences. And these models leverage deep learning models, neural networks, and also natural language processing. And these help the chatbot understand and produce human-like responses. Now, on the other hand, rule-based chatbots adhere to a collection of predetermined rules. So they're very much rules engine based. And they use those rules for producing replies for the user inputs. Now, they utilize a sequence of if-then statements to verify the presence of specific keywords that are sent into the chatbot. And those are then used in understanding the user's input to deliver corresponding responses based on those conditions. Now, the architecture of rule-based chatbots, we could think of it in like three high-level components that are all interconnected. So what have we got here? We've got the user interface, or the UI. We've got the NLP engine. And we've also got another engine, a rules engine. And here, the UI, this is where the users interact with the chatbot, and the NLP engine processes the inputs, and then the rules engine determines the appropriate response. And in some rule-based chatbots, NLP engine may be overselling a little bit what this component does, because some simpler rule-based chatbots might rely only on keyword detection without utilizing full NLP techniques. But this is the basic idea. So let's ask a rule-based chatbot a question. What are the operating hours of the electronics store? Now, the chatbot would derive a conditional statement that detects entities such as operating hours and electronics store. And then based on these predetermined entities and context, the chatbot can determine the user's intent and generate a predefined response, like the electronics store operates from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Now, at a high level, the architecture for a generative AI chatbot, well, it doesn't look so different. We can think of it also in three high-level components. So at the top, again, we have the UI, or the user interface. We also, again, have an NLP engine. And now here, instead of the rules engine, we have a large language model, an LLM. But if you look between or beneath the surfaces here, there are some fundamental differences between these two. Now, the NLP engine in a rules-based chatbot that extracts intent, entities, and context, we said, but the NLP engine here, combined with the large language model in a generative AI chatbot, can handle much more complex language structures and nuances. It can better understand the user's input, context, and intent. And large language models do not rely on pre-written rules, but they've been trained on vast amounts of text data, which allows the chatbot to generate contextually relevant and human-like responses. One of the significant advantages of generative AI chatbots is their ability to learn and adapt over time. By continually updating their knowledge and refining their language models, these chatbots can provide more accurate and relevant responses. So, does this spell the end for rule-based chatbots? Are generative AI chatbots always the better option? Well, the answer to that depends, as ever, on your use cases. So let's briefly consider a couple. First of all, let's consider frequently asked questions and customer support. So that sort of scenario. Now, in this sort of scenario where we have user queries that are relatively simple, relatively predictable, a rule-based chatbot can be an efficient and cost-effective solution. For instance, in the context of a customer support scenario for an online store, a rule-based chatbot can quickly provide answers to frequently asked questions about shipping or returns or product information, stuff like that. Now, for sure, a generative AI chatbot could fulfill this use case too, but this could lead to increased complexity and cost without a significant improvement in performance. Or actually, if we're not careful, it could lead to worse performance as LLMs introduce the potential for sharing incorrect information through something called hallucinations, which are instances when the chatbot produces responses that aren't grounded in reality or factual information. Okay, what about another scenario? What if we want to consider things that are creative or open-ended? Now, in this sort of situation, we're talking about things like generating story ideas or sort of brainstorming ideas, things like that. And a generative AI chatbot is the obvious answer here. With its advanced language understanding and creative capabilities, it can excel at these tasks. It can think outside the box and generate unique and engaging content or ideas. Creative writing tasks are my favorite use for this type of chatbot. Rule-based chatbots are limited by their predefined rules and lack the flexibility to generate innovative, reasoned responses. Now, for now, in the current times, I think we can say that both chatbots have their place. Generative AI chatbots are becoming more powerful and may eventually supersede rule-based chatbots in many cases. But today, generative AI chatbots still have concerns around privacy of training data and a tendency to sometimes produce output that is misleading or incorrect. But look, this is an exciting time in the chatbot space, and I hope you share just a little bit of my obsessive interest in where this journey will take us.